Hi, my name is Bobby McGee from Bobby McGee Endurance Sports and BobbyMcGee.com. This week's section, I'm going to be talking a little bit more about mental skills again. And one of the things that we haven't quite proved yet, because we haven't been able to get an MRI that can fit on the skull of an athlete while they're riding their bike or while they're running at high intensities, is the central governor theory, which is put forward and proposed and quite extensively researched already by Professor Timothy Noakes from South Africa, one of the world's premier exercise physiologists and cardiologists. And the central governor theory says that our brain will not allow any single system in our body to fail catastrophically. In other words, before our legs give in, before our blood pressure is too high, before our blood sugar gets too low, before we get too hot, before we get too cold, our brain will not allow us to access that system that is putting us into that problematic area. So in other words, if your leg muscles are starting to fail, the brain might be the cause of us cramping so that we cannot continue at that intensity. Similarly, in the heat, we will start to shut down once our core temperature approaches 40 degrees centigrade, because the brain will not allow itself to get damaged or any other system in the body to do that. That still has to be proven, but I'm a big fan of that. But what it does point to in terms of performance athletics is that we have a warning light, like a fuel light, that goes on when we start approaching what might be our limits in these capacities. So in other words, when the fuel light in your car goes on, we start to get a little sense of apprehension. We don't want to run out of gas. We don't want to get stuck at the side of the road, all right? So we go to the gas station and put in gas. But actually, we still have 30 miles in the tank. We still have quite a way to go before we are actually out of gas. Now, our body has got built in what we call a homeostatic system. This homeostatic system is a series of warning lights. For example, if our blood sugar gets too high or if our blood sugar gets too low, certain things in our system, certain hormones in our system start telling us that we need to take it easy. And how that works is that when you start reaching these homeostatic levels, all right, we start getting these senses that we're slowing down. And to become good endurance athletes, what we can do is when we start having these sensations, we start challenging them and saying, all right, I'm getting a little closer towards my limit, but there is a lot further that we can go. And so when you're going out and doing your quality workouts and you start experiencing these sensations, start questioning these sensations, start acknowledging them and saying, look, I can go a lot harder, all right? I do need to be paying attention here, but I also have quite a lot of fuel left in the tank because I'm involved in a performance sport. I'm not just trying to necessarily keep myself safe and then stop and slow down because then I don't achieve my time goals or my performance goals. So go out there, challenge these signals that you get from your body. If they're really, really important, your body will start to shut down, governed by that brain, all right? But if they're not and you push a little harder and you find out you can tolerate that, now you're doing actual endurance training for your mind. You're starting to teach yourself to push yourself further and push what they call the envelope. So good luck out there, and go out and challenge your homeostatic reflexes.